there's a snowman above my head. That's awesome. Anyways, so he's still over there. Hi, Olaf. Okay. So I thought I needed something cheery to bring into this video that is going to be very morbid and grotesque and gross and make myself throw up and possibly faint, and I don't even throw up on roller coasters. So, if you guys don't like blood or inserting things into other things, which sounds like a really terrible Cards Against Humanity card, then you probably shouldn't watch this video. Otherwise, hey guys, we're about to get really personal here. So, a lot of people have been saying about like soft cups this, soft cup this, menstrual cups this and that. Yes, this is going to be a Shark Week video, so guys, you probably want to tune out to this before you throw up. You will throw up, probably. I don't know how in-depth this is going to get. Personalness, but you never know. So, I've been using it for 2 days now. So, I inserted it fine, whatever, whatnot, took a little nap with Doopy. We were very happy with that. And then I went to go to the bathroom to check on things, go to the bathroom, whatever, whatnot. I was leaking. I was like, all right, so I'm going to take it out, reinsert it like I've been doing, whatever, whatnot. Not a big deal. So I got to take it out. And I feel it, but I can't get a grip on it because it is so far up. So I was like, okay then. So, per the websites and several YouTube videos, I clench all my muscles, pretend I'm giving birth, which I've never done before, so I don't know exactly how that should feel. But I can tell you right now, it feels awkward if I'm doing it right. Clenched up my muscles and sit there and try to go, and heave-ho and heave-ho and try to deliver this menstrual cup. And it does not budge. It does not move a muscle. I don't know what heck's going on with it. So heave-ho, heave-ho, push, push, all those wonderful things that pregnant people go through. Nothing happens. So it says, okay, go take a shower. Okay, so I go take a shower. Squat down in the shower, go heave-ho, heave-ho. By this point in time, I'm pretty much passed out. My head is gone, whatever, whatnot. I have so bad of cramps. Just like, life sucks. So finally, I'm just like, heave-ho, I can feel it more. And I'm like, oh, I can get my finger on it. It still will not pull out because it's created a suction on the side of, yeah, interesting stuff. Yes, very interesting stuff. Yeah. My stepdad was shocked by and he did not know I was filming this video. And so now he just heard some interesting information he did not need to know about me. Anyways, so trying to deliver, quote unquote, this thing. Pushes out, it is stuck against the wall of something. I don't even know where that thing is now. So, finally, before I went to the shower, I called the company and said, hey, look, there is something stuck inside there that should not be in there. What do I do? So, of course they don't answer. Leave a voice message, hey, call me as soon as possible because it is stuck and that will not come out. So, go take a shower, pull it out, and finally I can release the suction enough to where it's painful, but I can pull it out. Finally, the stupid thing is out. Stupid thing. So I'm like, alright. Like, well, now that that's out, let's just stick it right back in because I'm still bleeding from my uterus. Because uteruses hate people. So, stick it right back in, try to like put it somewhere, somehow, different, so then that way it does not get stuck in, but I can still pull it out, and I can still touch it, so it's to the point where I can pull it out. It's so funny, because my stepdad's with an IV right now, and it's rather interesting to watch him react to this. So, finally to the point where I can, like, pull it out, keep it in whatever, whatnot, and then it's still leaking, so I'm just like, you know what, forget this. If you guys can see the facial expressions coming from him right now. Forget this. So I just, like, yank the thing back out. I'm like, all right. I'm like, well, tampons. I'm used to tampons. Just stick a tampon in there. My lady bits, my genitals, decided to reject a tampon. If you're at a tampon rejected, it's very interesting. So you put it up the normal place, you gotta shoot it up, and it comes back out. Yeah. Except for when it came back out, it might have been still messed up down. I don't know what was going on. And so when it came out, it was like stuck, so I had to like pull and then like it looked like it had been, like, pulled. Like, it didn't look like it usually does when you pull it out. And I didn't even have it in, like, for a second. So, pull that out. Put a pad on. I'm like, okay, you know, let it, like, maybe my pH balance is off balance and everything because of this thing. Let's just let myself heal itself. Let's just put a pad on. So, currently, I feel like I am wearing a diaper because I've not worn pads religiously for a year, 2 years. Seems like forever, but I know I was wearing pads in high school, I think. And plus, I was on birth control, so I didn't have as straight of periods all the time. So I'm not, so I got so used to wearing tampons, not wearing pads, and I don't like the feel of it at all. So I was going to go somewhere today, but now I'm like, I am not going anywhere. I have an excuse. I am not going anywhere today. So I'm going to sit and watch Good Luck Charlie and eat ramen noodles like a regular college student near finals for an entire day because I'm just like, nope, not going anywhere, not doing anything. Maybe I'll register my cow calendar. By the way, guys, insert. I am not, I don't have cannot form words.